Shenanigamers, and welcome back to Darkest Dungeon. So we've now gotten to the point. Let's just clear out this roster here. So we've now gotten to the point where all four of the bosses in our main areas are present. We have the Siren in the Cove, the Wizened Hag in the Wheel, the Swine Prince, the Wards, and the Necromancer Apprentice, and the Ruins. Now, of course, these are boss missions, so they will not be easy fights. We also have a couple of short missions, one of which is Veteran, and a long mission. Let's see what these relics we could get are. We get the Man-at-Arms. Guardian's Shield. Yeah, the Guardian Shield for Man-at-Arms. If we beat the Necromancer Apprentice, which give the Man-at-Arms plus 10% protection, plus 50% healing received, and plus 10 dodge if they're in position 4. You usually don't go back there as far as I know. Nova Vex Solaris doesn't. We hardly have any skills they could use back there. Well, actually, I guess they have 4 they could use, but still. That's definitely an interesting one. I'm sure there's a build that'll work great. The Candle of Life for the Antiquarian, plus 50% healing skills, and plus 15% max hit points, or HP. That's pretty good. The Sanguine Snuff. Plus 8% crit if Crimson Curse Bloodlust, and plus 15 dodge if Crimson Curse Bloodlust. And the Hell's Hairpin for the Hellion. Plus 10% crit if Torch is below 25, and plus 10% crit if the Torch is below 25, plus 15 accuracy if the Torch is below 25, minus 10% debuff resistance and or debuff resist, minus 10% debuff resist, and minus 10% bleed resist. That would open Crimson Figure up to some bleed. If we were to get that, that would give them the crit and accuracy of the torches, though. It would also make it easier to debuff them. And for this mission, we get a bleed and rip. For minus 20% blight resist, plus 20% bleed resist, and plus 20% bleed skill chance. That can be good. Bullseye hat for the Musketeer, plus 8 accuracy, plus 5% crit, minus 4 dodge, an interesting one. And the Evasion Incense for the Occultist, plus 8 dodge, minus 1 speed. Well then, let's see here. We could go for the Necromancer Apprentice, undoubtedly an undead enemy. The Siren, who's likely Eldritch. The Wizened Hag, who I would guess is likely human. And the Swine Prince, who is likely Beast. And with all these relics we have here, or trinkets rather. This could be interesting. However, I think we are going to take some other people and get them leveled up a bit more. I'm going to try and gear up for these fights here. So, let's go ahead and take Malbank, since they're pretty much perfectly fine. Oh, Perfectionist is really bad. I did not realize that was what they had. I'll go ahead and get rid of that. Perfectionist has got to go. And of course I picked Winded. Well, we're gonna go ahead and just spend double on it because Perfectionist is just that bad. It's worth it. Hmm. Luckily, no one else is sick. Yeah, Melbank, you can just stay there for a while. Okay. So then now, we will embark instead on a different mission. Quest. Keep getting the term for that wrong. It's just gonna happen. We didn't take Mortimer out much. We could bring this. Yeah. I'll take Mortimer. Solaris. I think we're going to be going to Cove here. Let's see. We can bring that beach shut on. They're an Elder Trader now, so I think definitely benefit us. I have it. Alright. Anyone hit anything? You have read resistance, so dodge. You have nothing, really. And nothing that we give you. You have a high virtue. And you have nothing we want to give you. We could give you some. In the world, we're gonna head out on a short mission here. Bring our usual kit. Food, shovels, anti-venom, bandage, some herbs, tea, holy water, laudanum, full stack of torches, and on we go! Thralls will explode if left for too long. Cove. We're getting very close to the boss fights here, I think. Because if we get our resolve up too high with these other characters, then they won't actually go with us on these easier missions.
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
Quests, not missions. Keep making that mistake. I'm going to get this right. Anyway, let's see what we can find in here.
Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies.
Alright, first room. Room back. We're up first. We need some protection. You, with your 75 protection, or 75% protection, could definitely do with it being cut down. Stress fire. Shut in. Four resistance to it is higher, but you hit them both. Very nice. This guy's as good as done. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot on you. Thank you. something's done, they'll go away. You'll have to hit someone else.
Ow.
The spear. I haven't been speared. Go ahead and heal. Of course it's one shot. I'm gonna have to kill.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Bleeding. Yeah, we'll be gone. And then there we go. We're good on stress, so we can take that.
Fresh disadvantage. Give them no quarter.
Take them out. And rush. Ooh, very good.
Formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
And a scout. Very nice scout as well. So, curio up here. The crate.
Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
No, yep, there it is. There's a trap. 60, 60, 80, and 90. But all, you're up. Good job. Good job on that one. Right. We need it here. Now we go to this room.
The darkness holds much worse than mere trickery and boogeymen.
What can we use? You know what? Distributed. And then shuffle. Ooh. That was bad.
Self-preservation is paramount at any cost.
Oh. We know what that does now. And we know what Japan can be doing for a while.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
One spot here is this curio. All of this that we can. And into the room battle we go. There they are. Good dodge, Shaban. Thank you for the guns. So where's it gonna land it? Let's get it started on this, because this is what we're doing. And get rid of that deflection. We're the ones who call it. And we're all there. Let's get this mark on you. You will have a lot of protection if you don't like light spreading. You have to get that protection. You can probably lost some of it. They are using the bull. Yikes. Don't like that. So we'll hit him with the rampart. Knock him back. Yes. Barn of the barrier. Close. More protection. It's fine. We'll go ahead and get some bleed down there. Or at least one. And you know what? Do it. Beast mode. Hit him with the slam. Ow, the spear. Take focus from anyone. Okay. Great. Thanks. Ooh, good dodge. Open up for them with the location of the Cestus. Hit. Resist the bleed. Let's go ahead and stun. Nope. You know what? Go ahead and get more now that we're back into position. We're gonna try again. Don't miss the stun. There it is. I get rid of that guard, not that it matters. Don't take enough damage, get some stress, let go down even further. Keep inspiring. There we go, get the music. Taking a lot less stress now. Stress is going down slowly but surely. And let's send the hound after this guy. That'll do it. He's done for. Ah, spear. So bam, you're taking the hits. Ah, they keep rending. Ah, God, the bleed.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Go ahead and set up a defender for bam here. You're pretty much done for, one way or another. So let's go for you. I don't like you stressing us out. You have the lead, I'll take care of it. There'll be no blood left for the leeches. I'm just glad there aren't any leeches coming through here.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
And another inspiring tune. Bring them down. Another end. Resist the debuff. And resist the bleed. Take that one back. Easy girl. Best to sit this one. Fair enough. Sit it out and chill out.
Unnerved, unbalanced.
That is pain.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Rend your gloves. Resist the bleed. Take the debuff. It's only one damage.
Masterfully executed.
Destruction is all I can give this world.
This expedition at least promises success.
Doing it for a good purpose. Let's keep going here. Okay. This. This is a heal, not a stress heal, if I remember right. So let's give this to you. A nice crit heal. Okay, there's a little bit of a stress heal, but not much there. And the medicinal herbs. Let's just search it. Ah, the red plague. I'm gonna have to get rid of that. Yep, lower bleed resist, lower hit points, and lower crits. As one would expect, the red plague is bad. Pull up the light here a bit. Sorry about that little break cut there. Shenanigamers. I had to take care of something real quick, but we're back. And there's another pool. Can we use holy water for this? I doubt it. Nope. Gotta be the anti-venom. No, screw it. Resilience is heavy. More resistance is until can. I will not say no to that. Especially not as we get right into a fight. I don't think you can call me to,
ears.
Right out there.
Blurred vision. The end approaches.
They're gonna stick Woody Lando in for you. Sam deserves more praise than any of you. Well, good for that hound. In the meantime, could you maybe help? You know what? Since it deserves enough praise, let's see what it gets. Lower strip, 13%, minus 13% stress, plus 50% damage, and plus 15 accuracy for 3 rounds. That's pretty good. That is very, very good. Well then, yeah, you need to go down. It's somebody over here, Lucian, whichever one. There's a my gosh!
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
No, do not fall. Yeah, fearful indeed. Flee, flee while you can. Yeah, go ahead and set up the protection for him here. Yeah, give him a guard. You do not know. Send the hound. And the sealed slash.
Injury and despondence
damn you,
set the stage for heroism. Or cowardice.
It's a certain doom that I feel. Power doom. Okay, go ahead and heal yourself up and get into a bear for this one. Thank you. Alright. And then, yeah, we're gonna go ahead and keep inspiring.
The blood quickens.
People are getting stressed out. And none of us are liking that. Gonna try to stun you. Yep, get the knockback. Move, stun. Ceremonial. Step aside. We alone can bring these fiends to justice. Well, you're equally effective from there, so technically you're not wrong. And you after that one. Bleed. This, stress down. You can keep doing this, give it up, get more stress down. And Joker. Reward will still be mine to claim. Whatever. Out of the frying pan, into the fire. Well, you're not wrong. It's stressing everybody out, Mortimer. Wounds there. Again, playing an inspiring tune for them. Super slash. We got that protection. And we're going to push them. Nice big old hit for 8 there. Another inspiring tune. Just getting pretty low. Ball here, at least I die at 3 now. I've seen such horrors already. And yeah, give him a manifest. Take what we got.
Seize this momentum.
Reboots. Plus
push
back.
On to the task's end.
Oh, I suppose that's something. We'll go ahead and pop the torch here, get that light level up. We could return to the hamlet. There's only one room left. We're all pretty stressed out. Two of them are afflicted.
Despite its morbid aspect, this twisted, cavernous maze seems almost traversable.
Better not to mess with that. Are in our favor still. Mortimer, that dud hitter, minus 5 crit, or minus 5% crit if hit points are below 50%, and warns adventurer. -20% stress in the warnings. So Mortimer might be getting added to the warnings again.
With Zombie.
Maybe Shabam will too. Wield foe. +20% stress in wield. Warns adventurer. -20% stress in warnings. Well then. Definitely a possibility.
A fresh irritant to some. A sanguine memory to me.
Now, if I remember correctly, yes, we could make the performance hall for the jester right now, which gives them -10% stress, +2 speed, and +20% damage on their finale. So in theory, we could do that. However, the Sanguine Vintners is still very much one that I would like to have before we get into the Crimson Court. Because eventually we will end up getting into that. So we have a Critical Stone, +3% crit, -1 speed, and a Dodge Stone, +4 dodge, -1 speed. Well, first things first, we need to get rid of that plague on Solaris. He's pretty stressed out, hopefully he can calm down afterwards. But, right now, that's gonna happen. Mortimer, you only meditate, so go ahead and do it. And then Veral, you can go ahead and pray to a higher power. Let's light guide you indeed. And then Shabam, you're freaking out, man. You will only drink. And we cannot get you to drink because the caretaker is currently enjoying that activity and there's only one spot. We keep saving up to upgrade the stagecoach. Which is a very good idea. Now, we have a leper, a bounty hunter, a shield breaker, and an abomination. A wheeled scrounger. And a winded. But they also have Expose. Back one on a melee hit, which bypasses stealth. Ups the chance for the enemy to receive crits, or ups their crits received chance by +8% crits received chance. De-stealths the enemy and gives them -4 speed. That's pretty good. Yeah. And Malbank is no longer a perfectionist. We should make sure that no one else has perfectionist as well, because stress on a miss is awful. Doesn't look like anyone has it. Okay. So, what do we do now then? Do we up how many we can possibly hold? Or do we up how many show up? Or do we try to start working on skills and weapons and armor? Let's see what they all take. So we have weaponsmithing and armorsmithing. One, we could get one of these two. Put us about halfway there. In the guild, instructor mastery. We could get one of these as well. In fact, we could get both of these.
Some may fall, but their knowledge lives on.
Instructor mastery 2 will definitely help, because now we can up people's skills to level 3. We are going to do just that in time, later, because that will be expensive. And the blacksmith, we can get one of these two. We can either upgrade their armor or their weapons. And on top of all that, right now we could still upgrade the size of the barracks. then let's we could get more experienced recruits later. Right now, I'm making sure as many people are coming in as possible and that we have the availability for everyone we want is very important. So then let's go ahead and upgrade the stagecoach network. So now we'll have 5 every week. And then once we get more deeds, we can upgrade it again. Or we can work on... Actually, we can upgrade the furnace right now.
Fan the flames, mold the metal. We are raising an army.
Alright. We can also unlock more camping skills. Some of them, in fact many of them, only have 3. Is there actually anyone here we have who only has, who doesn't have 3 camping skills? There is not. Nobody here has a 4th skill. In fact, Malbank is the only one who doesn't have 3, and they have 2. Well, we'll fix that in a moment. Off screen. That is going to be it for this episode of this series. That is going to be... Yeah, I am going to... This is the same intro I try every time, and I trip over it. Alright, let's try this again. That is going to be it for this episode of Darkest Dungeon. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this or other content that we put out on the channel. We're going to keep putting it out for you. Remember to leave a comment. It helps us out a lot. It really, really does. Also, remember to leave a comment if you want to have one of the heroes on this roster named after you. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!